Hello everyone, Zorin just announced that it is now possible to perform an in-place upgrade of its operating system to another major version of the operating system. Before this, if you wanted to upgrade the Zorin OS, you needed to back up everything and then perform a clean installation and then restore everything and then reinstall all the applications. So this is not the case anymore. And this is a very good news. So in this video, I'm gonna show you how to perform this in-place upgrade from my Zorin 15.3 education version to the Zorin 16.2 education version. So let's switch to screen recording to show you all this. So this here is my Zorin OS installation. And as I told you, it is 15.3. And at the time of this video, the latest version of Zorin OS education is 16.2. So the first thing you need to do is to make sure that your Zorin installation is updated. So go to the Zorin menu and then go to System Tools and here click on Software Updater and make sure to update all your system. So here my system is already updated. I'm gonna click on OK. The second thing you need to do is to install the Zorin OS upgrader. So you need to open a terminal window for this. So Ctrl+Alt+T on your keyboard, it will open a terminal window. And here in the terminal window, type in this command, sudo apt install zorin-os-upgrader. And then hit enter and put the password for your user. And now the Zorin OS upgrader is being installed. So now it is installed. If you launch it now, it will not work. You need to restart your computer for it to work. So let's restart the computer. Key in reboot. And the system will reboot. Now, after you install the Zorin OS upgrader, you can find it under System Tools here. So let's go to System Tools. And you see here that you have Upgrade Zorin OS. And I wanted to tell you that at the time of this video also, the upgrader of Zorin OS is still in beta. But maybe when you see this video, the upgrader will not be in beta anymore. So if you didn't find the upgrader here, or for any reason, if it didn't work, you need to perform this command. So open the terminal window once again, Ctrl+Alt+T, and this is the command. So I copied and pasted this command from the Zorin OS website. So it is gsettings set com.zorin.desktop.upgrader show test upgrades true. And by the way, all these commands, I'm gonna put them in the description below. So let me close this one and let's perform the upgrade now. Just before performing the upgrade, I wanted to show you the version of Zorin OS that I have now. So I'm gonna go to Zorin menu, and then here I'm gonna go to System Tools, and then Settings. And under Settings, I'm gonna click on Details, and you see that I have Zorin OS 15.3. Let me close it. And here on the desktop of Zorin OS, I have also my working documents, and I have a document. And I'm showing you all this so that you see that everything will persist. And I'm gonna show you the version of LibreOffice that I have now, because LibreOffice comes with Zorin OS. So if I go to About LibreOffice, you're gonna notice that it is 6.4. So I'm gonna close it. And after the upgrade, everything will be upgraded, and even LibreOffice. And I have Skype here, and Skype is logged in with my Knowledge Sharing Tech account. So now I'm gonna perform the upgrade. So click on the Zorin menu, and then go to System Tools. And then under System Tools, click on Upgrade Zorin OS. And you see that Zorin OS is checking for upgrades. And it found that it has the Zorin OS 16.2 education. And this is what we want here. And if you have the Zorin OS Pro, you need to put it here. For Zorin OS Pro, there's a slight difference from education because you need to put in your information so that the upgrade will be successful. Here I'm performing the Zorin OS upgrade for education only. So let's click on upgrade. And you need to put your password. And then click on authenticate. And by the way, for the upgrade to succeed, it needs 9.2 gigabytes of free space on your hard drive. So make sure you have this free space. And on this screen here, you have a certain recommendations from Zorin. So they tell you to back up your files before the upgrade. And go ahead, back up your files if you don't have a backup for your files. And then when you're ready, click on upgrade here. And the upgrade will take place. So this step here of the upgrade takes a bit of time. Just give it time and wait for the upgrade to finish. So now the installation of the upgrades is finished. And the upgrader is cleaning up the system. So now the upgrader is prompting us to restart the PC. Let's restart the PC. So click on restart here and click on restart once again and wait for the computer to restart. And the user is still the same. So let's log in with our user. And let's check the version of Zorin OS now. So click on the Zorin OS menu, system tools, settings, and then go to about. And you notice here that we have Zorin OS 16.2. So here it is, let me close it. And Skype restarted automatically and it logged in also with the same user. So let me close Skype. You notice here that the Skype icon on the desktop changed, so it's no longer working. So this is because I think the upgrader is still in beta. So I'm gonna delete it. I'm gonna re-put Skype on the desktop. Let's see the work docs. And I'm also curious to see if LibreOffice was upgraded, and I'm sure that it was. So here's LibreOffice starting. And you notice that it's telling us that we have now LibreOffice 7.5. Let's double check it. And this is the LibreOffice version. It is 7.5, as you notice. So we have your documents and we have LibreOffice upgraded. And all we have to do is to create the icon of the programs that we have on the desktop. So for me, it was Skype. So I'm gonna simply recreate it here. And I hope that Zorin will correct this error in the future. So let's add it to the desktop. And here's Skype working from the desktop. If you have any questions or comments, feel free to put them in the comments section below, and I'll be more than happy to answer all your questions and all your comments. I hope that this video was useful to you. In case it was, please share it, subscribe to my channel, and give this video a thumbs up. I would really appreciate it, and this will help my channel greatly, and this way you'll not miss my future videos. I'm Eloy from Knowledge Sharing Tech. I want to thank you all for watching and see you in the next video.